Hello and good day. Today we're going to talk about how writing a book has changed my life. So at the end of this, I'm going to give you three tips that you can take away from this story in order to help you pursue your passion. So it was back in early 2016, I was working a corporate job, and I found myself pretty happy with the 9-to-5 lifestyle. My weeks were typically filled with working, going to the bar for happy hour, or going to a friend's house till late at night for me to go back home, sleep, and wake up and do it all over again. So at this time, I was very fortunate for what I had in my life. I was enjoying life, I had a good steady job, I was occupied and busy, my weeks were always fun, but I felt that something, didn't know what it was, but something was missing. So every Sunday, I go through what Viktor Frankl, author of Man's Search for Meaning, calls Sunday neurosis. I would wake up on a Sunday morning, stare at my alarm clock, and say, "You are not getting out of bed until you figure out a purpose with your life." So every Sunday, I would spend my time staring at the alarm clock, hoping for a breakthrough, thinking of ideas in my head, and usually it would end with me being upset, getting up out of bed, forgetting about it, until the next Sunday came around and I found myself starting over at square one. We go through our week, we do a lot of work, or we go to our job, and then by the end of the week we feel like we're not doing enough. I'm talking about the ones who really do feel that Sunday neurosis, that really do feel like there is something missing. So one day I went to the gym and I found a playlist, I found a song, decided to listen to it, and the closest thing to a breakthrough happened. I'm on the treadmill, I'm listening to this song, and immediately an idea for a story comes into my head. So at this point, I have never written a book, and I've never thought about this random story that popped into my head. So right here is the meat and potatoes of the video, because what happened after this moment became a streamline of the biggest changes that happened in my life. The first one, time commitment. So I would usually go out maybe 5 days a week, you know, happy hours and such, and it started dwindling down from 5 to 4 to 3 to 2, and I found myself dedicating more and more time to working on my book. Of course, there were the side effects. A lot of friends kind of fell to the wayside. I wasn't showing up as often as I was. It also showed me the true friends that I have that really stuck through and were cheering me on and are still my friends today. So you start to see the first big changes in your life when you're dedicating more time to your passion and dreams. The second is your physical and mental health. So you really want to focus on, what can I do to give myself the most energy when I sit down? And diet and exercise are the top two most important things you have to do as far as physical activities go. So the second is your mental health, and you start to realize different tactics and techniques that you need to do so when you sit down or when you perform, you are at your peak. Different techniques could be meditating, reading, researching, whatever it may be. One of the big things that comes with this too is your emotional investment in your work. So the biggest turning point here is that I realized this book was my purpose. This was what I needed to do with my life. I needed to put all of my time and energy into creating this book. And I'll get to the specifics on the book at the end of the video. The important factor is that this book really did become a very important part of my life. Third, and the most important part, is the identity piece. So I said, who was the person I wanted to be? What was my message and what did I want to do? As you could see, I made a YouTube channel about helping people. So that was one of the main reasons why I created this channel. It's been taking me a while to write, so I said, I want to give content to people now. So this chain reaction of thought had me really thinking about where I saw myself, and I saw myself being a life coach, mentor, and writer. With that being said, I have a video about a life coaching success story that I had with my first ever client where we talked about if we wanted to be something, we have to be that person now. We have to have that identity piece now. What are you doing now that's going to get you closer to your end game? Find something to dedicate your time to. Find something that's worth promoting your mental and physical health, and let it take over you. Decide at that moment who it is you want to become and do every little step, inch by inch, to becoming that person. Okay, so as far as the book goes, I'll give you a little elevator pitch and kind of leave it at that. The world is thrown into chaos with breaking news of their inevitable extinction. The world government forms a team able to control the elements to help their dying planet, but it seems this team has done more harm than good. Hope now rests in a young visionary named Mike, who discovers a dark truth and must decide if he can hold the fate of the world in his hands. That's all I got for the book as of right now. I'll give a quick timeline at the end of this video so you can see, if you're interested, what the four-year process going on, yeah, just about 4 years of writing this book looked like for me. Fact remains, I've become an entirely different person since starting to write this book. I've grown mentally and physically with each passing year. I've dedicated time and energy to this to the point where I feel like I've changed. I feel like I've accomplished something, even though I haven't finished the book yet. Hopefully you can take away these steps and use them in your life to find your passion. And if you like what you heard, as always, please like, comment, and subscribe. I love responding to comments. And if you can, share it with someone who might be in a funk or might be looking for something to accomplish with their lives. And let them know that there is always something to do. Until next time, we'll see you.